The next behavior we're going to discuss is probably the easiest to use out of all the behaviors, but that doesn't mean it isn't as useful. In fact, it's one of the most important behaviors to understand if you're concerned about your game's performance. The destroy outside of layout behavior does one thing. It destroys an object as soon as the object leaves the layout. There are no parameters, no actions, no expressions. It simply destroys an object when it leaves the layout. Why is this so important, though? Well, imagine if you have a space shooter. On the screen is the player's ship, and it can shoot bullets. Then the enemies are spawned, and each of them shoot bullets. Before you know it, there are tons of enemies who have left the layout, each still shooting bullets. The computer still calculates the speed, angles, position, collisions, etc. for every single object, even if it's outside the layout. Once a bullet leaves the layout, it will never be useful again. There's no reason for the user's computer to continually calculate its position, speed, etc. This layout is set up with a tower cannon and a bullet object, with the bullet behavior applied. I've set up an event, so when you press the spacebar, a bullet is spawned at the tip of the cannon. Let's take a look. When I press space, a new bullet is spawned and travels off to the right of the screen. Let's look at that again, but this time I'll click Debug Layout, right next to Preview Layout. With Debug Layout, we can see a list of each instance of an object, and all of the information we have about that object. If I click on Bullet, this number 0 is the single instance of the bullet that I drug off the top of the layout. You can see its current X position here, constantly rising as it flies endlessly outside of the layout. If I press space and fire the cannon, each bullet that's fired will be listed here. If I select one of them, you can see its X position being calculated every frame, even though this bullet is far outside of the layout and will never be used in-game again. I'll select the bullet, click on Behaviors, Add New, and select Destroy Outside Layout under General. If I debug the layout again, you can see there are no instances of the bullet object. The sole instance of it, which was outside of the layout, was immediately destroyed. If I shoot the cannon a few times, you can see the bullet instances that are added to the layout, but as they leave the layout, they are removed from the list as they get destroyed. If I shoot as fast as I can only get about 7 bullets spawned at any one time. That's much less taxing on the system than having hundreds of bullets flying off into nothingness for the duration of the level. As you can see, destroy outside layout is not a hard behavior to understand, but it's an essential behavior to have added to your toolbox. By utilizing this behavior when necessary, you'll drastically improve the performance of your games. Thanks for watching. If you found this content helpful, please consider supporting me on Patreon. Comment, like, and share this video, and subscribe for more tutorials. See you next time.